Hey guys, let's do a Wednesday Wisdom COVID edition. Let's talk about life right now. I don't know about you, but I for one am glad that when I turn on the news, the stories coming in and broadcasted are ones of community involvement, neighbors helping elderly, social distance dance parties with strangers, virtual online family game nights and dinners. To be honest, I enjoy watching the news now more than I ever have. We aren't arguing over bathrooms, genders, politics, or religion. We're spreading stories of hope and looking forward to the future. Stories of parents learning to homeschool, or parents realizing how vital teachers actually are. Stories of how important first responders are and how nurses and doctors are at the front of our lines right now in this warfare on our health. Sure, there are the occasional press conferences and political banter that still takes place, but mom and pop stores are helping their communities, and likewise, people are ordering takeout from places they've never noticed before that may just simply be down the street from them. I have friends in California that are donating money to keep family friends back home. I have even talked to my family more during this quarantine than I have in the months since I've seen them at Christmas. I'm an extrovert. I need people. My love language is physical touch, so I get it. This is hard. Some people are living alone and don't have a spouse or family like I'm fortunate enough to have, which is even more of a reason to think outside the box, get creative, and bless others in any way that you can. Make it a point to contact multiple people, family, or friends every few days, and on the off days, contact people that you haven't spoken to in a while. Rekindle friendships, allow forgiveness in areas you didn't think possible prior to this quarantine, and pray for a softened heart to let people in and let a ministry mind become the forefront of your thought process. Let's love others in Jesus' name, and let's make the most out of an incredibly unique situation that we're currently in. We have time. So much time. So answer the phone call that you normally would screen. Answer the text that you normally would put off. Download a new game to play with family. Pick up a book that you've been meaning to read and actually read it. Write a letter to someone and mail it. Buy a gift for someone and ship it. I've had to do so many Zoom prayer sessions and videos due to unfortunate circumstances that have taken place during this time. It's unfortunate that we can't be there in person, but let's be joyful that we can find ways through technology to still be in each other's lives. Say I love you often. Say I'm praying for you, and then actually remember to pray for that person. Have date nights. Friend date nights count too. Stay encouraged and be a light. Love you all.